Greetings, vinyl lovers. This is Patrick, the vinyl archivist, and tonight we're going to have a long overdue Van Gelder report. This will be number 7, and those of you who don't know, on the Van Gelder report, I probably take in the case of this video, I take a new release, which is Lou Donaldson Blues Walk on the Blue Note Classic series, and in this case, I'm going to compare it to the Analogue Productions 45 RPM 2009 reissue. So that's what we're going to be doing tonight. I have some clips that I kind of changed up the clips. I'm not going to post whole songs. I'm going to kind of do it Baraka P Dub style and just do short clips, and maybe that'll get me past the sensors and maybe be easier for you guys to compare. So let's take a quick look at these records before we start listening, and we'll take a look at the waveforms as well. This is the one that came out very recently. I think I got this a week ago. And this is This is the Blue Note Classic series reissue. These are done, as everyone knows, by Kevin Gray at Coherent Audio from the original master tapes. They're plated at Optimal and pressed at Optimal. I'm not positive about where they're plated, but so this is the new one. This runs you about $25, I think. Now this is the 2009 reissue. This was put out by Analogue Productions in 2009. This was mastered by Steve Hoffman and Kevin Gray when they were still working together at Acoustech Mastering. So this is probably an all tube system. This is 45 RPM limited edition. This is number 1,553. I'd say this is two records at 45 RPM, and this will probably run you about $120 right now on the open market. So they both have, you know, the nice jackets. And these, you know, the classic series are not going to have the artwork. Like, this one doesn't have the artwork either. Sorry. This is not a Tone Poet or a Music Matters. But I don't think this is a gatefold either. Let me see. I've looked at this a while. Nope, no gatefold. Most of the Analogue Productions were not gatefold. They just have two records. And in case you want to see what the label looks like, it's your typical, looks like a Music Matters. This is the 45. So the jacket, probably the Analogue Productions, is a little bit glossier, it looks like, to my eyes. If I get this back in. Here, I'll take this out too. Why not? Oh yeah, for sure. So this is glossy looking, as you can see. This one is not. So I'm not really a jacket guy, but if those of you who are, those are what the jackets look like. Okay, so before we go to the clips, let's look at a couple of waveforms from the two songs we're going to hear from. So let me share this, get rid of this. Okay, so this one is the first song. This is the Analogue Productions of the self-titled Blues Walk. So get a good look. And here is the classic. Switch back to the Analogue Productions and the classic. So they're pretty similar. Not any compression going on or anything. So let's go to the second song. And my cat's about to jump up here. So this is the Analogue Productions right here for Play Ray. Here is the classic. Analogue. And the classic. So as you can see, the waveforms are very similar. I don't put a lot of stock in waveforms, but they do kind of like give you a decent picture about what's going on. So let's go on to listen to the clips, and we'll meet back afterwards.
Thank you.
Okay. So what did y'all think of the clips? I will give you my opinion. In my opinion, the Analogue Productions has a little bit fuller, deeper bass sound, low-end sound, especially on the drums. To me, when they hit, I can, you know, really, really, really hear the, what would you put it, the whole fullness of the drum. Whereas on the classic reissue, it seems like it's kind of a little bit muted. But the classic seems to have a little bit better high-end. And but that could also be because the Analogue Productions was cut on an all tube system, so it may have rolled it off a little bit. But I mean, overall, I think they sound both sound very, very similar for something that cost you $25 as opposed to $125. I mean, it's kind of a no brainer, but I mean, if you have to have the absolute best of the best and price is no object for the stereo, go for this. I believe there is a Music Matters Mono. I have the Music Matters Mono, but I don't have the SRX. That was one of the last SRXs, I think. But like I said, this is the new classic is stereo, as is this. That's why we compared these. I did not put the Music Matters into the mix because it's mono. And it really doesn't make any sense. So let me know what you think in the comments below. And I hope to have another Van Gelder report pretty soon. And hopefully to see you Saturday at the auction. Bye, everybody.